What's up, YouTube? Welcome or welcome back to the channel. Y'all, today we are finally doing a scrub take video. I'm gonna be doing a back table setup. This video, long awaited on my end. Like, I've always wanted to just show y'all my back table setup. So I feel like most of the video, I'll add some commentary, but it'll pretty much be following along and like just seeing what I'm doing. Like, basically right now, I'm opening up my pack and then I'm gonna get to separating the items that I do and do not need. So just watch along and I'll keep adding some commentary to what I am doing.
I'm outside in an AMG, right outside, TT, two-turn baby girl, you know me. Still with the dolls that I grew beside. All the niggas round me.
So typically in this bag, I'm looking for anything that I know I need for the procedure that isn't in the pack. So as far as drapes, equipment, sutures, extra instrumentation, that's all I'm looking for here, y'all.
I just caught a shorty off a Finsta. Just the one I'm really a screenshot. Where did I been living on?
So now all these items that I picked out, I'm gonna go ahead and place them on my back table very sterilely, because now that this table is opened up, everything that goes on it also needs to be sterile. So that's what I'm doing right now. And we got a couple items, so just keep on watching.
Rather see my heart turn crystal. I can't even find a guy on mission. Right now I'm just stuck inside a crib on my own. Soon as I free up, I'm about to.
Alright, so now that my gown is unraveled on my mail, I'm popping up my gloves. I'm a 6.5 double. If you're a scrub tech watching this, what size gloves are y'all? And lastly, before I finally scrub in, I'm just gonna remove the lid of my instrument. And I'm gonna check the filters, make sure we're good, so that when I come in, I can just grab it and all I gotta wait for them to do is check it. Now we're at the scrub sink, y'all. We're actually getting ready to do our scrub. Typically, I use the Betadine scrub brush and the Betadine soap, but as you'll see, I'm walking all around the hospital looking for my Betadine soap. But it just, I don't even think it was available. Yeah, it wasn't available. I ended up having to use the chlorhexidine, which is cool too, but Betadine is just so much softer and it gives me a smoother feeling. Like, I don't know, Betadine over chlorhexidine. If you're a scrub tech, comment below which one you prefer. So yeah, we're getting started on the scrub and I feel like this is pretty much self-explanatory too. Basically, I'm just gonna get to scrubbing away from the top of my fingertips all the way down to 2 inches above my elbows. So you'll see how I do that here.
Pop up on your phone like I'm outside in an AMG, right outside, PT, two-turn baby girl, you know me. Who am I? All the niggas around me, right in the guy. Gotta watch your time cause it's flying right by.
Two-time
baby girl, you know me.
I'm outside in a
AMG, right outside, PT. Two-time baby girl, you know me.
All right, now that the scrub is complete and our hands are all dry, I'm gonna take this hand sanitizer antiseptic. This is just agar that we rubbed on our hands. This will make our hands sterile before we go in. We're gonna enter with our back first and we're gonna put our gown on. Someone else is gonna seal our gown up, hopefully sooner rather than later. And I'm gonna get to setting up this back table.
What's left of us? What's left of our lives? It's only you, it's only me, it's only us at the end of the night. I remember when you couldn't tell me a thing. Now you talk so much, it drives me insane. Would you could do some great? So what can I say to you? When I'm off that, had to fall back. You got everybody thinking of all bad. I was always holding you down. You down.
Alright, so now it's time to actually move some stuff around on this back table. So I'm gonna make sure to utilize every single edge of this table, okay? Just in case we go open, emergency case, like anything that's gonna be added to my table, I wanna make sure I have space for it. And then I'm gonna go ahead and drape my mail, and I'll move a lot of stuff there just because starting out with the surgery, a lot of the stuff will just already be on the mail, so I can easily just pass it from there instead of my back table. And my back table will have more space so that I can have my set there.
Hometown hero. Do anything for some C-notes. At what cost?
Hit Mercedes, buy some free cars.
I know. I just make songs. Who am I to sound as how this shit goes? Fuck everybody.
You wanna be my equal. You only need you to have love. It don't matter. You don't even know the man.
That ain't even a man.
I said it's gonna be relaxed. I didn't.
Sometimes I wanna be you.
Wait.
But you know I won't do that.
Baby, you should know this. And it's so confusing, finding the right ways to express. We in love, it's a fear, it's a drug we do, I guess. An addiction we won't admit. But baby, you should know this, that I ain't going, and I ain't blowing no smoke.
Yeah.
you know that I'm with you when you bought the lounge truck, cash and double bag and bottle cool. It ain't nothing you can ask for, I see myself when do. Got the Cartier skeleton and you got one too. You ain't tripping about these I ran through. And you always on your, so I salute. But I'm always on the move, switching plays like I switch shoes. Put on my chains and with my move. Just stay the same, don't get confused. I'm one you will never have to lose. It ain't too much you gotta prove. Don't bring it up if you ain't got proof. I hit the gas and I go zoom. I let my cash go through the roof. Can't miss a beat, I stay in tune. And I ain't going nowhere till I'm 6 feet with a tune.
I mean, I've been sober, but you should've known it. And I wasn't going, and I know you noticed I've changed. But I'll be your woman always, always a better.
I be so sick, you just a contradicting. I be so bold, myself, and you come fuck me. I feel so ordinary, said when you around me. Treat me like gold, or you marry me out. Arguments, you air me out. Tripping about your whereabouts, and I can't keep no conflict with you. What can we just rub it out? I don't want no sex with you, you know you my plug, and I can't shake this habit, no.
I've been out, baby. I've been reminiscing. Baby, I'm missing.
Okay, so by now I'm just gonna add some context as to what I'm actually doing on this table with my instrument. So right now I'm taking my speculum, I'm just screwing that together, placing it on a towel because I will need some lube for it, so I'm gonna just keep it under there until I receive that. Then I'm just following along with the rest of my instrumentation. Looks like I'm grabbing some clamps, Kelly, sponge sticks, tenaculum, just the basic instrumentation that I know I'm gonna automatically need. So yeah, that's literally what I'm going through right now on my stringer. So also here, I was just putting my drapes in the order of use. As with most of the things on my back table, when you saw me doing the chords earlier, along with the instrumentation, everything's just gonna be in the order of use and not taking up too much space, which is why I took that little cord up under the drape because it's not gonna be needed till the end, so let's just hide that away. And then I tucked my gloves into the gowns, that's for the surgeon, so I wanna already have that ready. And now I'm getting ready to make some sponge sticks. This is probably the final thing I will do.
I hate you.
I do. If you
make you feel this nightmare. If you wonder if I hate you, if you to make me feel just like this, what I would do to make you feel just like this. And if you wonder if I hate you.
So now that my back table is finally complete, I'm gonna cover it up with my back table cover because this masterpiece does not need to be messed with, okay? So yes, this was my setup. I meant to say it at the beginning. This is a setup for a vag hysterectomy. So yeah, and to my future surge techs out there, just know that everything comes with time. Like with back table setups, obviously you're gonna have a certain time that you begin with, but the more you do it, the more you find your methods, you're gonna cut down that time. So be patient in your progress, and you know, take your time, take everyone else's advice and critique, because that's what's helped me along the way. Some methods I have on my own, but then other methods I've learned from other people and I've made it work for me. And yeah, that's my best tip for y'all. But here I am. I just wanted to show y'all me doing a count with my nurse. We're making sure to count all the softs and the sharps. So that's what I'm doing right now. I counted my blades, suture, hypos, all that good stuff. And then I'll also show the end, me receiving my fluids of sero water and saline and my meds. My meds, it didn't show the like full process. I wanted y'all to see me like filling up the syringe and stuff, but it's fine. This is what we have for y'all. But yeah, I really hope y'all enjoyed this video. I was really hesitant on putting this video out, but I'm like, you know what? Footage is footage. I took my time and recorded this, woke up early. So I hope y'all enjoy this video, and I probably will definitely do another video on this because it's just a must. Like, I love showing y'all my little back table setup, and even just editing this was pretty interesting. So this is my first time doing it. Next time I'll know like what to and what not to do and what to pay attention to. So yeah, make sure you leave this video with a thumbs up, subscribe, and put on post notifications so y'all can know when the next video is coming.
It's Jay again.